Goat versus fish. In the beginning, there was goat versus fish, the goat fish. And goat versus fish said that there should be goat and that there should be fish. There is no alpha or omega. There is no black or white. There is no good or evil. There is only goat and fish, and goat versus fish. Welcome to the Goat vs. Fish podcast, recorded at the world-famous Comedy Store, Los Angeles, a place of Goat vs. Fish. Goat vs. Fish speaks to you now, speaks to you. You are one with Goat vs. Fish, forever Goat vs. Fish. And Goat vs. Fish is one with you. You have many questions, yes? Who is Goat vs. Fish? What is Goat vs. Fish? Why is goat versus fish? But there is only one question. Are you goat or are you fish? Ponder it now. This is Goat versus Fish. Wrestling. Wrestling! Is it goat or fish? It is difficult to say if wrestling is a goat or fish, for wrestling seems to be a way to versus. A goat and a fish lock horns and fins and try to immobilize one another so they cannot frolic or swim. Goat versus fish would like to see a goat and a fish wrestling, if the goat and fish agree to versus in this way, of course, only if they agree to versus. But goat versus fish has not seen ones who wrestle and say if they are goat or fish. So until a goat or fish does say it is a goat or fish and does wrestle, then wrestling is a false versus for the fence sitter. The fence sitter that chooses neither goat nor fish. Conga drums. Conga drums. Are they goat or fish? There are so often two of these what the ones call drums, yes? Goat versus fish suspects that one is goat and one is fish together, and when you versus with the conga drums, yes, there is much celebration that excites many goat and fish. But suspicious that a goat and fish would be together in such a versusly way, not forming the unity of the goat fish. Are they fence sitters? Are they fence sitters? Are conga drums fence sitters? Goat versus fish thinks so. And what of Mighty Mouse? A Mighty Mouse? We know of the Mighty Verses. It was not so long ago. And there will be another, forever the Mighty Verses, forever goat versus fish. But what is a Mighty Mouse? What is a mouse? Is it a goat or a fish? And why does it seem to verses in such a peculiar way, singing, "Here I come to save the day"? It means that a Mighty Mouse is on the way. What way? What way is it? Is it a way to choose goat or fish? Goat versus fish does not think so. Do you partake in these fence-sitterly things without saying if you are goat or fish? Always leaving goat versus fish, not to mention the ones, guessing, wondering, pondering if you are a goat or a fish? These are fence-sitterly times. Fence-sitterly times. Or perhaps you read from what ones might call the Great Gatsby, a long versus, a false versus. It seems to be written, yes, it seems to be written, this Gatsby. But it does not seem to be goat versus fish. It does not seem to be goat versus fish. Anyone who would partake in such fence-sitterly fencing is surely a fence-sitter. Surely a fence-sitter. Goat versus fish just knows it. Goat versus fish would like to ask such a one, if it is goat or fish. But goat versus fish suspects a one like that is not about anymore. But perhaps it is, simply waiting for the right verses to reveal itself. to goat versus fish, hoping that goat versus fish asks it if it is goat or fish. And that's the way it goes. And that's the way it goes. Today, goat versus fish speaks to a one, speaks to another one. And what do the ones call this one? What do the ones call this one?
Melanie Vessi.
Melanie Vessi, yes. Goat versus fish is pleased to meet this one. Pleased to meet and to speak to this one, yes.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Yes, always thank goat versus fish. This one is already thanking goat versus fish. Yes, goat versus fish is pleased. Goat versus fish is pleased. Goat versus fish finds this one very curious. Firstly, what does it say upon you? What does it say upon you? It says, you can say it, you can say it.
Detroit versus everybody.
Detroit versus everybody. Detroit versus everybody. This is goat versus fish. Is this not goat versus fish? Tell us of this versus Detroit versus everybody. What is this versus?
I'm originally from a suburb of Detroit, and this t-shirt was for sale at the airport on my way back from the Motor City Comedy Festival, and I had to get it because I thought it was so badass.
Because it was such a false versus for a fence sitter that did not wish to be goat versus fish? Is that what goat versus fish is hearing from this one?
I am not a fence sitter.
You're not a fence sitter.
I am not.
But goat versus fish does not know. Goat versus fish is still not convinced that this one is not a fence sitter.
Okay.
For this one, goat versus fish has been looking at this one, yes. And this one does say it is a wild animal, yes. A wild animal?
Yes.
But what is an animal? Is it a goat or a fish? You would think one would say it is a wild goat or fish if it was a goat or fish, but this one says it is a wild animal. Explain yourself, one. Explain yourself.
I think specifically this one, as I point to myself.
Yes.
I think I am goat, wild animal, not fish, wild animal.
Oh, you're a wild goat.
Yeah, sure.
If you're a goat, you should say that you are a goat. Do not say, I think I am a goat. Are you goat or fish?
I am goat.
It is a goat. It is a goat. We celebrate the goat. The goat has triumphed in the verses within.
Yes.
Did triumph over the fish. You seem like a confident goat, yes?
Mm-hmm.
And how is the wild animal that is a goat different from the wild animal that is a fish?
I think the goat is just more rock and roll. Have you ever seen a goat's eyes? Those eyes are badass.
Yes, yes. Goat versus fish has seen many goat, yes.
Such amazing eyes.
And you speak of rocks, yes? These are of the land. The goats are of the land.
Yeah, and I think goats do eat some rocks. So, yeah, sure.
Oh, they consume the land. Yes, they do survive off the land, yes, to versus, to grow stronger, to versus the fish, yes. Have you versus the fish? Have you versus the fish lately?
No.
Oh, you have not versus the fish lately.
No.
But what of your greatest triumphs? Surely you have some triumphs over the fish for a goat so confident as this goat.
What do you mean triumphing over the fish?
Ah, yes. Well, there is a versus, yes. Let us say that you are a goat and you are a goat and you are moving about the land, yes. And then you come upon the sea, yes. Perhaps it is a lake that is the sea, or perhaps it is an ocean that is the sea, and there is a fish. There is a fish. It looks upon you, yes. Or perhaps it is one that says it is a fish. Perhaps it is one that says it is a fish.
Ah.
And so it is a fish.
Okay.
And you versus that fish, yes.
Yes, I understand that. I also just watched the Godfather trilogy, and they kept delivering fishes to people and saying,
"Ah, they bring fish.
You sleep with the fishes. He sleeps with the fishes.
Sleep with fish."
So it was a way of, you know, the gangsters, the mafiosos would send messages. So they, when they would kill someone, and then they would wrap up a fish in newspaper with a piece of the person's, like a article of their clothing, and it was, the message was, you know, like, you know, whoever sleeps with the fishes, it means they're dead.
Ah, the end of a goat or fish, yes.
Yeah.
Goat versus fish has heard of this one, has heard that this one almost was ended once, yes? Is this so?
Yeah.
Ah, yes, you laugh about it, yes, you laugh. Perhaps it was a funny way to end. Goat versus fish is wondering.
It's
yes,
a way,
it's
funny
wondering.
Way of putting it. A funny way of putting it. Almost ended.
Almost ended, yes. When a goat or fish ends, goat versus fish is not pleased, because if a goat ends, then that is one less goat for a fish to versus, and
sure.
That is less goat versus fish.
Yeah, understood.
It is the same for fish. Goat versus fish does not want to see any goat or fish end, yes.
Yeah.
For those who do not know this particular versus that this goat had, describe just the simple things, the simplest things about this. For those who do not know, Goat versus Fish is pleased that you are enjoying
this
yourself.
This is hands down my
fish,
favorite
yes.
podcast so far. By a long shot.
You have heard it.
Just being here with you. This is a total joy.
Yes, you have heard it once. Say it again. Say it again for all the ones who are listening.
I am thoroughly enjoying myself. It is an honor to be with you.
Thank you. Thank you. It is an honor to be with Goat versus Fish. It is an honor to be with Goat versus Fish. Yes, yes, yes. This one understands Goat versus Fish. Yes.
Deeply.
And Goat versus Fish enjoys being with you as well. Enjoys being with you.
That is fantastic.
Yes, let us see where this versus takes us. Yes, let us see where this versus takes us, Goat. Yes.
Let's do it.
So for the ones who do not know, what are the simple things about the way in which this goat was almost ended?
This goat was almost ended because her ex-girlfriend shot her.
Oh. Yes, that is a way. Goat versus Fish has heard that that is a way to end a goat or fish, yes?
Yes. Well, it's also very interesting that you say that it's an ending because I'm currently working with somebody because I have a lot of pain around this topic.
Ah.
And I'm currently working with somebody who's telling me that it was actually a beginning.
Ah, it was a beginning for this goat. It was a
yeah.
beginning for this goat. Of course, in the beginning, there was Goat versus Fish. But there can be beginnings within Goat versus Fish. And what is this new beginning for this goat? What is this new beginning for this goat?
Well, I think that my pain comes from the fact that when it happened, when I was shot, a lot of things ended for me. What I perceive them to be as ending. But the person that I'm currently working for now is trying to explain this to me as a birth.
Ah, is this to say that before you were a fish and now you are a goat, or have you always been a goat?
That is a very good question. I'm not sure. It could be maybe because I don't necessarily identify with the fish, so maybe it was like that. But in my current state of mind, it's very difficult because I look upon this time before getting shot as a very powerful time. And so that's why I see it as an ending, because it I feel like it took that away from me. But this person that I'm working with is currently trying to explain that I have grown since stronger.
Yes,
and
yes.
that I'm actually probably closer and more realized to what I actually always wanted, and that was a fantasy back there.
Goat versus Fish has heard of these fantasies. Many have them. They have a fantasy that they are Goat versus
yeah.
Fish. The ones have a fantasy that they are a goat fish. They have a fantasy that they can be a bird or a bear
sure.
or a dragon or something that is not
yes.
a goat or a fish.
Yes.
They are fence-sitters, mostly fence-sitters.
Not
ones.
Based in reality. Yes, I probably was a fence-sitter.
Ah, you were a fence-sitter.
Maybe that's what it was.
Perhaps it was. Perhaps it was. A fence-sitter, a true fence-sitter, if there is such a thing, would not even know that it was sitting on the fence, so fence-sitterly it is.
Yeah, I think that that's probably the closest version of it, yeah.
And now you are a goat. Goat versus Fish is so pleased that now you are a goat, that you are a goat, and the Goat versus Fish is speaking to this goat, for there have been so many that are fence-sitters that have come to speak to Goat versus Fish in the previous verses, in recent verses, yes.
That must be so frustrating
it
for
It is
you.
Very frustrating for Goat versus Fish. Goat versus Fish says that in the beginning, there was Goat versus Fish, the goat fish, and that there should be goat and that there should be fish. What is simpler? What is simpler? Yes, it is Goat versus Fish. Of
yeah.
course, Goat versus Fish is also very deep. Yes, very deep. We can always go deeper with Goat versus Fish. But choosing goat or fish, why do you suppose that ones do not choose goat or fish? Why would they not choose goat or fish?
Because I think it's maybe a commitment. Maybe they don't want to commit. Maybe they don't. Maybe they see that it could change for them. They're not willing to like dive deep.
It could change for them. It could change for them. This goat could change into a fish. This goat could change into a fish if it said it was a fish.
I think that that's actually okay. I think that's different from being a fence sitter.
It is. Goat versus Fish would much prefer that a goat became a fish or a fish a goat than becoming a fence sitter.
Yeah.
Do you see yourself returning to the fence? Returning to the fence, is there a risk? For you said there was much pain from the previous verses, yes?
Mm.
Does it bring you back to the fence, so painful it is to sit upon it?
I don't think that I would ever return back to the fence. Only
Goat versus Fish is so pleased, never returning to the
fence.
Yeah,
because
yes.
I feel like too much has happened. I've been too pushed. Now, should something happen and I change into the fish, I think that that would be okay.
Ah, if you became a fish. Yes, you could become a fish if you wish. Are you goat or fish?
I'm goat.
It is a goat. It is still a goat. Tell
us
about
this. Life is
goat.
Long. Life is long.
Ah, yes, many verses to come. Many verses to come.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Tell us about this goat. Tell us about this goat when it is out doing the goatly things that it does. Yes. What are the things that this goat does that it does call its verses? What does verses mean for this goat?
This goat does a lot of stand-up comedy.
Ah, Goat versus Fish has heard many, many. Why is it that so many that are here say they do this stand-up comedy? Ah, it is the comedy store. Perhaps there is something to it, yes. But continue, continue.
Yes, a lot of comedy. Actress, filmmaker. Yeah, I have my own company during the day. I help people promote themselves, called Promotional Rescue.
Ah, you help them promote themselves. That is, Goat versus Fish has learned of the ones when they speak of promotion, they are speaking of spreading the word of Goat versus Fish.
Yes, telling people on the social medias and yes, all that
yes.
stuff.
Yeah. Yes, the Twitter and the Instagram, yes, yes, and the Book of Faces, yes. Yes. Do you have them? Goat versus Fish
all
uses
of
them. Yes, you
all
can
of
tell
them.
The ones. Tell the ones how they could communicate with this one.
At Melanie Vesey. On all my social media, and then melanievesey.com.
You have heard it. You have heard it. Yes. Do you think that you could help Goat versus Fish to spread the word of Goat versus Fish? Of course, you are doing it now.
Of
you are
course.
Doing it even now.
I'm
yes.
going to, as soon as, I mean, I'm going to post the photos today, but then as soon as it's available, I will shout it from my goat-like roof.
Yes, yes. Oh, you're a roof. A roof is a goat? Goat versus Fish thought a roof was a fence-sitter because there was one that was called Breaking Bad, yes?
Oh.
And there was one that was called a pizza that was thrown upon it.
Oh, yeah.
And then one built a 6-foot-tall iron fence, yes, to protect the roof, it called it, so that the pizza would not be upon it.
Yeah.
Building a fence to protect the roof, Goat versus Fish suspects that the fence-sitters would all come together to protect one another from becoming Goat or Fish. Of course, you should become Goat or Fish. Do not sit on the fence. You, do not sit on the fence. The one who is listening. So a roof is a goat. A roof is a goat?
No, I'm saying like the roof that covers this goat, this particular goat. The goat that I am, I do have shelter to which I will then stand on as the goat and then bah.
Are you bah?
Whatever
the goat is celebrating. Let us hear how this goat celebrates.
Like I guess the goat has more of that kind of childlike scream. I kind of did more of a lamb, but you know. Whatever the sound that a goat makes.
Oh, you are a goat. What sound does a goat make? You are a goat.
I'm so bad at it. I don't know if I could make a good sound.
But you are making many sounds right now, even as you speak to Goat versus Fish, and you are a goat. Is this not the sound of a goat?
I think that the way I'm talking now is the sound of this goat.
It is the sound of this goat. Yes, Goat versus Fish. That is the confident goat that Goat versus Fish knows. Yes, it is the sound of a goat. It is the sound of a goat. And what is the sound of a fish? What do you think is the sound of a fish? This goat seems very skilled at making the sound of a fish.
I'm classically trained.
Perhaps
so.
too skilled for this goat's own goat. How can you prove to the ones that you are a goat now if you can so confidently make the sound of a fish?
I think anybody that looks at me knows that I'm a goat.
Ah, this goat. Yes, Goat versus Fish was testing this one. Testing to shake its confidence, yes, but it knows that it is a goat. It knows that
I'm
it
rock
is
solid.
A goat.
I'm goat solid.
Goat solid, yes. High goat, high goat. It is a high goat. It is a high goat. Goat versus Fish was wondering. Goat versus Fish has seen this one. Has seen this one very recently. Yes, looked different. Looked different. Mm. Goat versus Fish was watching a versus. Was watching a versus. It was perhaps 2 verses long. And it was called Man on the Moon. You are familiar with this versus?
I am.
Man on the Moon, yes?
I am.
You did participate in the documentation of this versus, yes?
Mm-hmm.
What was your role in this versus? What was your role in this versus?
I played Carol Kaufman. I played Andy Kaufman's sister.
Ah, a sister. A sister. That is one that is close to another one, yes?
Yeah.
Yes, yes. So you would know this one. You would know this one that they call Andy Kaufman, yes. This one Andy Kaufman, yes.
Well, not Andy Kaufman. I played his sister, but so Jim Carrey was playing Andy Kaufman. So I, unfortunately, this movie was made after Andy's death. So I did not meet Andy, but I met Jim, who he also claims was very much embodied by Andy in the most recent documentary, Jim and Andy. So I was with Jim as Andy.
Goat versus Fish does not quite understand what this one means. Goat versus Fish saw what Goat versus Fish saw, yes?
Yeah.
But perhaps the ones that are listening understand this one. Perhaps the ones that are listening understand this one, yes. Goat versus Fish did see this one, that is the sister of Andy Kaufman, yes, and did see this one that was called Andy Kaufman, yes.
Yes.
Now, when Goat versus Fish saw it, yes, it was said that this one that was called Andy Kaufman had cancer, yes, had a cancer.
Lung cancer. He had lung cancer.
And is cancer goat or fish?
Mmm. I would say fish.
You would say it is a fish. How is cancer a fish?
I don't know. The first thing that popped into my head is that it swims throughout your body, that it has a very kind of loose sense about it.
If it is a fish, it does not seem like a pleasant fish. It does not seem like a fish that any goat would ever want two verses.
Yeah, no.
It seems that if the fish triumph in this verses, that it is the end of a goat.
It was the end of Andy. Some people get rid of their fishy cancer. Unfortunately, Andy wasn't successful.
Why would one choose to verses a fish in this way? Why would one choose to verses in this way that it could end the very one that verses in this way?
Like, why did Andy die? I don't know if I understand the question.
If it is a way to verses, yes, if it is a way that this fish does verses, you can verses the fish that is called cancer, yes. Why would a goat ever want to verses this fish if it could mean the end of the goat?
Oh, like, why would I ever want to fight cancer?
Many say they do versus cancer. They say, I am versusing the cancer,
yeah.
Yes.
And I think Andy did try and fight the cancer quite a bit. I mean, he used a lot of holistic, you know, methods. He also didn't smoke, which was why it was very shocking that he had lung cancer. They were very confused by it.
Lungs, goat versus fish, has heard this. It is a way that you take in goat versus fish and then you release goat versus fish, yes?
Yeah.
Yes, we can do it as well. And yes, in with goat versus fish and out with goat versus fish. And in with goat versus fish. Hold goat versus fish. It is within you now. And out with goat versus fish. Yes, yes. Let us move on. Let us move on from this unpleasant fish. Yes, let us move on from this unpleasant fish. Of course, if there is anyone that thinks cancer is a goat or a fence sitter or some other thing that would be a fence sitter if it is not a goat or a fish, you can tell goat versus fish. You can tell this one. You can tell this one if you disagree, yes?
Sure.
Now, upon hearing that this one, Andy Kaufman, had the fish that is cancer, yes, you did say, what a crock. Yes, you said, what a crock. What is what is a crock? Goat versus fish is wondering what a crock is. Yes, is it a goat or a fish?
Well, the crock, what you're referring to is the scene in the movie that I did when I was with the family because we were looking at his x-rays. And as most people know, Andy was very famous for pranks. Very, very deeply perfected pranks.
Describe to goat versus fish what is a prank. Goat versus fish has not heard this before.
Like a trick. Like a trick on his family and friends. You know, he would dress as other people. Tony Clifton. He would take on other personas. He would go very, very far with this. So the family didn't believe when he got the diagnosis that he had cancer. And my character, Carol, she was like, this is bullshit. That's what she means by a crock.
That is a crock. Yes, it does sound like a crock. Yes, yeah. A crock. Yes, goat versus fish. Has heard a crocodile as, yes, another thing that is not a goat or a fish. Yes, it sounds like this one, Andy Kaufman, was engaged in many false verses, yes?
Yes.
False verses.
Absolutely.
Showing as if it is a goat or a fish versing in one way, but then it is a fish or a goat, and it was not even a verses of goat versus fish. It was some other thing, so fence-sitterly.
Well, I think that he was so good at the false that he actually made it kind of a true. So I think that that's why people were so tricked by him and why they consider him a genius.
You say a false verses can be a true verses.
I think when Andy Kaufman is involved, yes.
Goat versus fish thinks it sounds like a fence sitter. A fence sitter always being false with the verses, yes? Always being false with the verses.
Mm-hmm.
Always wondering if it is a goat or a fish. Goat versus fish could not even see if it was a goat or a fish by the end of the verses. What kind of verses is it if you do not even know if the goat or fish triumph? Goat versus fish wonders, yes?
Yeah.
So then you did say, he wants us scratching our heads, asking ourselves, is this real? You could be asking, what is goat versus fish? You could be asking the true question, are you goat or fish? So why would this one, Andy Kaufman, want us to ask ourselves, is this real, when you could be asking, is this goat versus fish?
I don't know if Andy had the wherewithal to ask whether or not it was goat or fish. I think he
did. It did not?
I don't think
he
did.
Why are so many so impressed with this one if it did not even ask the one question, is it goat or fish? Goat versus fish is not impressed.
I think he predates the goat versus fish, and I think he planted the seeds for the world of goat versus fish.
It sounds like you are saying that there was something that was before the beginning, but of course in the beginning there was goat versus fish. Goat versus fish did say this in the beginning of the goat versus fish podcast. How could this one be before the beginning of Goat versus Fish?
There's always a time before the beginning.
Goat versus Fish has heard this. Has heard this said by many a fence sitter.
I don't think that's fence sitterly.
Ah, explain how there could be something before the beginning. Goat versus Fish does not understand it. In the beginning, there was Goat versus Fish.
Well, because I think that there's infinite time.
Yes, forever Goat versus Fish. Yes, ah, forever. Yes, it is forever Goat versus Fish. Yes, that is so. That is so. Yes, yes. So what of these ones? Yes, this one, Andy, yes, it did present itself as one. And then the Tony Clifton one, yes, that you did say, yes. Mm-hmm. It presented itself to the many ones, yes, that it did speak to. It presented itself in many ways. Sometimes it did not seem to be one Andy Kaufman, but seemed to be another altogether, yes?
Yeah, are you talking about Bob Zemuda?
All the ones, it was always showing itself to be some goat here or some fish there or even a fence sitter here, yes? So what of these ones? What of these ones who would not be their own goat or fish, but instead present themselves as another false one that is not the one that it is? Yes, and you do not even know if you are talking to the goat or fish. You are just talking to this one. You do not even know if it is the one that is the one. What do you say to these ones? Why would one behave in such a way as this? It does not seem like goat versus fish at all.
Well, I think in the case of the other people who could have played Tony Clifton, I do know that Bob Zemuda did play the part of Tony Clifton when Andy couldn't do it or when Andy was pulling off another stunt and they needed Tony Clifton there. I think that Andy was adored by many people.
It did seem.
And that they would want even just a shred of what Andy had. And I think that they wanted to step into those shoes from time to time.
Ah, so they tried to be as that one.
I don't know if they could have manifested it for themselves, like maybe had the confidence or I'm not sure what the word is. I don't know if they could have gotten it for themselves. But when they got the opportunity to play the part, you know, with Andy, you know, in tandem with him sometimes, I think that people did take that role to be that.
To be
Tony Clifton.
To be Tony Clifton. And is that one, do you think that one is a goat or a fish? Goat versus Fish does not even want to hear it. Goat versus Fish wants to ask it if it is a goat or a fish.
Tony Clifton, I would say, is a goat.
You would say it is goat. Goat versus Fish did actually suspect that that one is a goat. Goat versus Fish cannot say much for this one, Andy Kaufman, but Tony Clifton, but then it did seem that Tony Clifton was Andy Kaufman, and so it is a goat, but then it does not seem to be a goat. Goat versus Fish does not know. Goat versus Fish wishes to ask it. Some say that this one, Andy Kaufman, is still about and that Goat versus Fish could ask this one.
No.
What do you say?
Andy is absolutely dead.
It is ended. It is dead. It is pitiable.
But maybe a beginning.
It is another beginning. This goat is very positive goat. Yes, positive. The ones call it positive. Of course, there is no positive or negative. There's only goat or fish. We could say that this goat is very goat. It's very goat in its goat. Yes. Mm-hmm. What do you say to the goat? What do you say to your fellow goat?
Keep goating. Don't stop the goat.
Do not stop the goat. Do not stop the goat.
Totes my goats.
Totes my goats. Goat versus Fish has not heard this. Yes, you say totes my goats to the goats?
Sure.
Sure you do. Yes, yes. It sounds like a celebration, yes? What do you say to the fish? What do you say to the fish that you are forever versus forever goat versus fish?
Just keep swimming.
Just keep swimming. Goat versus Fish has heard this as well, yes, yeah. That the fish should just keep swimming, yeah. Yes? What do you say to the fence sitter? What do you say to the fence sitter?
Dig deep. Find your goat, find your fish, make your decision, be a man, be a woman, get off the fence.
Be a goat or fish? You mean to be a goat or fish?
To be, you know, yes, to be a goat or a fish, yes, you don't have to be a man or a woman, you're right.
You cannot be a man or a woman, there is only goat and fish. There is only goat and fish. What do you say to goat versus fish? What do you say to goat versus fish?
What do I say to you?
Goat versus Fish is listening, yes. It is time to speak to Goat versus Fish.
I'm wondering where you get your high thread count towels. That looks like a very, very absorbent, beautiful towel combo you've got there.
Have you heard it? Have you heard it, ones who listen? Have you heard it, ones who listen? Goat versus Fish is speaking to a goat, a strong goat, a confident goat, yes? And yet, even this goat that is so ready to embrace goat versus fish, when asked, what do you say to goat versus fish, asks of the towels again.
Because they're so good. They're so good. And this goat isn't willing to pass up a good towel.
But what is a towel? There are no towels. All you see before you is goat versus fish. Goat versus fish has said it many times. Yes, there are no towels. There is only goat versus fish. Mm-hmm. What is a towel? Is it a goat or a fish?
I would say it's a fish.
Ah, it is a fish.
Mm-hmm.
Goat versus fish does have fish upon it, as well as goat, yes. Mm. As well as goat, yes.
Multifaceted.
Goat versus fish would like to thank this one. Would like to thank this one for being part of the Goat versus Fish podcast and for being part of Goat versus Fish.
Thank you.
Yes, always thank Goat versus Fish. Always thank Goat versus Fish. Thank you. That was Goat versus Fish. That was Goat versus Fish.
Did we do it?
The time has come. Goat, fish, and fence-sitter alike. To sing. To sing. To sing in celebration of goat versus fish. Let us sing in celebration of goat versus fish. The goat says, and the fish says,
glub, 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 glub.
And the fence sitter does not say either of those things because it sits on the fence and has not chosen goat or fish. And goat versus fish says,
are you a goat or a fish?
And that's the way it goes, and that's the way it goes. Thank you for joining Goat versus Fish. This is the word of Goat versus Fish. Follow Goat versus Fish on all social media, the Instagram, the Book of Faces, the Twitterverse, all at Goat versus Fish, all at Goat vs Fish. Subscribe, rate, and review the Goat versus Fish podcast on the YouTube and the iTunes and even on the SoundCloud. And if you, one who listens, be you goat or fish, have a celebration of Goat versus Fish, do send it to Goat versus Fish on the social media or to goatversusfish@gmail.com. That's Goat vs Fish. Send your celebrations and send your questions to Goat versus Fish, for Goat versus Fish may celebrate them or answer them on an upcoming versus. Join the Goat versus Fish discussion group on the Book of Faces to discuss Goat versus Fish with other goat and fish. And when you are out in the land and the sea, look about you. Look about you. Find one who is lost. Find one who does not know the way. And ask. Simply ask. Are you goat or are you fish? Are you goat or fish? Are you goat or fish? Thank you for joining Goat versus Fish. I am Goat versus Fish, the goatfish. And it was written.